Dr. Notley here, Winnipeg chiropractor and athletic therapist. Did you just bend over and your lower back tightened up? You're in lots of pain, you're not moving very well. We're experiencing acute lower back pain. And first, I'd like to reassure you that lower back pain does get better, and it can get better quickly. But in some cases, lower back pain can transition into chronic lower back pain. And that's what this video is about. What increases your chance of developing chronic lower back pain? This study recently, written in 2020, looked at the risk factors that increased your chance to develop chronic lower back pain. So here's the problem. 26% of people with acute lower back pain become chronic lower back pain. This makes a significant impact on our economy, a significant impact on our healthcare system, but more importantly, it takes a significant impact on your life. It affects your work. It affects your health. You may not be able to exercise. You may not be able to do the things you enjoy. You may not be able to socialize. It affects your mental health negatively. If we can find out ways to lessen your chance of having chronic lower back pain, or guide you in the directions to help you lessen that chance, it'll make a huge impact on your life. So the authors of this paper asked the question, is the transition from acute to chronic lower back pain associated with risk strata, and we'll discuss that, and or with early exposure to non-clinical guideline care or non-concordant care? And we'll discuss that as well. They define chronic lower back pain as pain that lasts for more than 3 months. They also said that the person had to experience pain that lasted for at least half the days over the last 6 months. Anything less than that was considered acute. They took all the people in the study and they broke them down into risk strata. There's low risk, medium risk, and high risk. They used a questionnaire called the Start Back Tool. And that tool is something that I use in my office, and it has a scoring of a maximum 9. And there's a subscore in there that looks at the psychological components of back pain. If you had 3 or less in the questionnaire, you were considered low risk. If you scored 4 or more and your subscore was less than or equal to 3, you were a medium risk. And you're a high risk if your score was greater than or equal than 4 and also greater than or equal to 4 in the subscale. They considered you experiencing non-concordant treatment if you were prescribed opioids, if you were prescribed benzodiazepine and or systemic corticosteroids on their own, but if they were also prescribed non-steroidal anti-inflammatories and or short-term muscle relaxants, that was not considered non-concordant treatment and it was acceptable. Also, they considered early ordering of x-rays, MRI, CT scans as non-concordant. And if you were referred to a non-surgical or a surgical specialist early in the experience of lower back pain, that was considered non-concordant treatment. I'd like to just tell you that there are acceptable forms of care early on in acute lower back pain, and the current guidelines are reassurance. Lower back pain does get better, and it can get better quickly. Also, very low likelihood that you're going to have something more sinister occurring. Not likely it's going to be a tumor. It's not likely that you're going to end up in a wheelchair. It's not likely that you're not going to be able to walk for the rest of your life. Also, maintain activity as best as you can. If you can work, do some work. Even if it's lower intensity, that's okay. Get out walking. Do some of the exercises I prescribe. It's also okay to use heat. It's also okay to use massage, acupuncture, spinal manipulation, those of which I use in my office as well. Those are considered acceptable. That's the current research says this is how we should approach acute lower back pain. Other variables that the researchers looked at, they looked at age, sex, race, ethnicity, health insurance, body mass index, your smoking status, your lower back pain diagnosis at the time of the injury, your psychological comorbidities. They didn't really discuss those. They just listed those. They also looked at self-reported lower back disability. So you got hurt. What couldn't you do? If you said, all I could do is lie down and that's all I could do, and I couldn't do any of my work, I couldn't do anything at home, that's more severe than somebody who said, hey, you know what, I was able to do all my home stuff, and I had some problems with my lower back when I was working. The more severe it was, they looked at that amount of disability. They looked at the clinic location of where the person came to see the doctor, and they also looked at the socioeconomic disadvantage of the people who attended and saw the doctor. Looked at all these variables to see what increased the chance of a person transitioning from acute lower back pain into chronic lower back pain. And this is what they found. Overall, 32% of people transitioned from acute lower back pain to chronic lower back pain. This tells you that acute lower back pain can last into chronic lower back pain, and it's not necessarily just going to get better in 3 months. And so we need to be aware of these risk factors so that we can make changes. 32%, almost a third of the population with acute lower back pain may become chronic. Those people who are in the high risk category, they were 2.4 times more likely to become chronic compared to the low risk group. The medium risk group were 1.59 times higher than the low risk group. And when we look at those, both of those categories has psychological components. So what we may have to consider doing when we see our patients is, if we see this, there may be some things that we can do in office, but we may have to refer them out to help deal with some of these other psychological components. The level of disability that the person had at the time of their the time of injury was also positively associated with the transition from chronic pain to lower back pain. So if you are experiencing a lot of pain now and you can't do a lot, that increases the chance that you can become chronic. So we need to deal with this, and we need to do our best to try and lessen your chance of having lower back pain. Also, if you're obese, if you experience anxiety, depression, if you smoked, if you had back pain that went down into your leg, also if there were psychological comorbidities, again, that's not discussed in there. And my suspicion is some of that can be related to anxiety and depression, but it may also be related to catastrophizing, thinking that this is the worst thing ever. I'm not going to be able to work for the rest of my life. I'm going to be in a wheelchair, or I'm going to have cancer. This is the start of cancer. These types of things can increase our chance of having chronic lower back pain. And lastly, the more of the non-concordant treatments that were provided early on, the more likelihood is that you will experience chronic lower back pain. So what does this mean to you? As a person dealing with lower back pain, it's important to get some form of care. Care that follows our current clinical guidelines. Get assessed, determine what's going on. Hopefully, a start back questionnaire is used so that we can determine, are there some psychological issues? Are there things that we might have to refer off to somebody else and see somebody who can help you with those things that are a problem? We also have to look at, you know, dealing with anxiety and depression. Do we need to see a psychologist who can help you out to get you through part of this experience of having lower back pain? Are you overweight? Should we be referring you off to someone who can help you with the lower back pain by dealing with weight loss? Are you a smoker? Should we be looking at changing that so that at the very least our body can be healthier? But there is effects of smoking that actually increases your chance of having disc issues. So learning, getting away from smoking, making you a healthier human being. And also being aware of what you're being you're being asked to do. You know, if you just have lower back pain right now, you don't need to get x-rays, MRIs, or CT scans right now. Later on, if we're not finding things improving, then some of those non-concordant treatments that were considered not helpful in an acute situation, when it gets to that point of not being, treatment is not being affected and we're not seeing things improve, then some of those things may be more appropriate. But right now, getting you active, getting you out of pain, getting you doing something that allows you to build your body back up to be a kind of having more armor and being more confident in your back can make a huge difference in lessening your chance of having lower back pain.